Hello and welcome to the Dave Trumbo Show presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. I'm Greg Royce, joined by Stevenson women's volleyball coach Dave Trumbo. And coach, you just wrapped up about a couple weeks ago with a ninth straight trip to the NCAAs after you won your eighth straight conference championship. Talk about the season overall as a whole and how it went for you.
Well, it's something that we certainly don't take for granted, and it seems like it gets harder every year. So yeah. We were just thrilled to go to the NCAA tournament. I felt like against Arcadia in the finals, we played our best match of the year.
Yeah,
we were hitting on all cylinders. We passed the ball well. I was just so thrilled for our girls to be able to come through and play like that and get that NCAA bid.
Yeah.
Got to go to Christopher Newport, who was the host.
Yeah.
So it didn't seem like a 7-2 type of match because we won the first one.
Yeah.
We kind of knew Christopher Newport was not playing very well, so winning the first set was huge.
Yeah.
Second set, they played better. Third set, we were up 17-12.
Yeah.
And we had every opportunity to win that game. We lost 25-23, and that deflated us a little bit.
Yeah.
And they had a huge crowd, pep band,
yeah.
You know, fans on all four sides of the court. So it was really a festive atmosphere.
Yeah. You talked about volleyball just seems like such a game of momentum. And I think back to one thing in the conference championship against Arcadia is you go out and win the first two sets. Arcadia builds a little bit of momentum in the end of the second set, takes a big lead in the third. I thought you did a good job and your team did a good job. You called a couple timeouts, not letting them get too far ahead to continue to build that momentum. And I think that made the difference in the fourth set, being able to come back and win.
But yeah, we did make a really nice run at the end of that third set. And, you know, we were so far behind, the chance of us winning weren't great.
Right.
But we had done that
right
during the season. We'd won some sets like that. We had absolutely nothing to lose.
Yeah.
In a match like that, you're right. I call timeouts a lot quicker.
Yeah.
Because if it's an opponent that I really feel like we can handle, I'll give the team a little bit more latitude
right
before I call a timeout. Yeah. But in a match like that, even when you're up 2-0, you're not playing around and you're calling a timeout pretty quick just to reset, you know, and take a break and see if we can get some momentum going.
Right, absolutely. So obviously, you know, you were able to turn, kind of do the same thing. You did were down 2-0 up there, then the regular season came back and won. You certainly didn't want that to happen in the conference championship
right
match.
And they had, and Arcadia just done that to Messiah in the semifinals.
Right.
So everybody was thinking, right. I didn't have to say it. Everybody was thinking, and I'm sure Arcadia was thinking the same thing. Well, we can do this again. We just did it on Wednesday. We can do it on Saturday too. But this time it was at our place.
Yeah.
And we had a nice crowd. And so it was, you know, it's a lot tougher to play when you're not home.
Yeah, absolutely. Talk about the performance of Simone Jess in the conference championship. You know, two huge matches and named conference tournament MVP as a freshman.
Well, I couldn't be more thrilled to have Simone for another 3 years. She has been quietly putting up good numbers all year.
Yeah.
She, you know, Katie Leffridge is getting the most balls. Simone plays, you know, towards the end of the rotations. And you know, she stands next to Victoria. So Victoria, good balls. Victoria's getting a lot of those balls.
Right.
But Simone had the opportunity and got a lot of great balls and got hot. And she just started to relax. And
yeah,
we've been kind of waiting for this to happen. And she had that kind of game on Wednesday and then did it again on Saturday. So, you know, moving forward, you know, we thought that she could do this.
Yeah.
And she really started, you start to really see the real Simone come out.
Yeah, absolutely. And just finally, just talk about your seniors. You know, obviously four straight trips to the NCAAs, four conference tournament championships, you know, All-Americas, Katie and Victoria. Just talk about what they've meant to the program and what they've meant, you know, to the university as a whole.
Well, we are really going to miss all five of them.
Yeah.
And, of course, to play, not only play 4 years of indoor, and a lot of them have played 3 years and going to play their fourth season of beach.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just, you know, they've got to be getting sick of me by now. But starting with Katie. Katie sat as a freshman.
Yeah.
She did not play a lot. She was playing behind Kristen Brooks, mm-hmm. could not beat her out, but played beach her freshman year. In the spring, I think that developed a lot of confidence.
Yeah.
She knew the spot was open, and it was a great example of somebody that wanted to win that spot, and she worked so hard in the offseason to win that spot.
Yeah.
And then, of course, turned into a three-time honorable mention All-American player.
Yeah.
And a go-to player, and somebody that probably didn't want to be captain, but learned to be a leader,
mm-hmm.
During her years here, so I'm very proud of her.
Yeah.
Victoria, this year, had her best season ever. And she, and that's to her credit, because she was in fantastic shape. Mentally, she was engaged. And of course, she has got a job at Johns Hopkins Hospital already. So she's not only working at Hopkins, she's got two clinicals and working at Hopkins and playing volleyball.
Yeah.
You know, so for her to put up those kind of numbers, to be honorable mention, All-American.
Yeah.
Just, you know, fantastic. You know, the anchors of our team, you know, are two setters. So we always had a senior on the court.
Yeah.
You know, Katie played all the way around, but Julie Nightwine and Caroline Dangell, you know, 3 years playing together. Caroline had transferred in her sophomore year, but Julie played all 4 years. So to have the two of them on the court all the time just to calm things down. Yeah. Julie's just so solid defensively, and Caroline is a risk taker.
Yeah.
You know, she will make the big play at the big moment. And last, Darian Heilman.
Yeah.
Darian is just such a solid passer and defender. Played in the front row last year. This year, Simone came in. Darian never said a word and just did her job as the DS and one of our best servers.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, Coach, well, we thank you all year for your time. And you know, may not feel like it out there today, but a couple months, it'll be beach season, and we'll chat again soon.
All right, thanks, Greg.
All right, for Dave Trumbo, I'm Greg Royce. This has been the Dave Trumbo Show.